Hey, this is Dave with Taboo Customs. This video today, we're going to be discussing a kit that we've developed to strengthen the upper control arm mount on the Jeep TJ and XJ Dana 30s. All right, so what will happen is that as you wheel your TJ, your Cherokee, a lot, and if you wheel it hard, you will eventually start to deform this upper control arm mount on the right side. And what will happen is this upper control arm mount is just a stamp piece of 10 gauge. You'll start to deform this mount and it'll start to actually fold inward. These two pieces will start to come together and you'll see this start to buckle. And we've seen a lot of people do homemade fixes on these. And you know, what we wanted to do was try to make a kit for those to try to avoid that issue in the future. So we made a pretty simple kit here. It really just consists of two plates. And the first plate will go on the front of the mount on the inside and basically allow us to weld it to the tube down here at the bottom all the way up around on the inside of the mount, and then the same thing on the back side of the mount as well. We'll basically weld an additional plate back there to just reinforce this back side of the mount. So we've got our shop TJ in the shop today, and we will take a look at how we weld those in. All right, so we've prepped for this by going ahead and disconnecting the steering stabilizer from here at the axle end, just pulling it back out of that way. That should give you some clearance. Now, this is a lifted Jeep, so we've got a lot more height here than you may have. However, you should still have enough clearance to get in here, although it will be a little tighter. So with that now out of the way, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna disconnect this upper control arm here, and then get it up out of the way. Now, for this bolt here is typically 3/4, and depending on the year Jeep, some of these bolts will vary. This bolt here is a 15/16, and it has a Torx, a 50 T50 Torx on the other side. Once you start getting, I think, into some of the newer years of TJs, you will actually have a regular bolt, and typically this will have a little tongue on it that'll catch down here to try to keep it from spinning, but oftentimes those will just spin. Just push it up out of the way, and usually because of the bushings, they'll kind of stay up out of the way. So now what we need to do is we're going to take our plates, we'll lay them in there, mark it out with chalk on the front side and then the rear, and we will clean those up. All right, so now we'll go ahead and put our plate in. Now the plate, if you hold it upright, you'll see that one leg is longer than the other. This leg goes towards the passenger tire when you put this in, and if you put it in the wrong way, it'll definitely fit a lot better one way than the other. So put it in there, make sure you're up against the tube at the bottom. Mark out your area on the inside we're going to need to clean up. Mark the tube. And one area you won't worry about is you won't worry about where this bushing is at up top. You don't want to weld to that bushing, just weld to the sides and the axle tube here. So now that we've got that done, we'll go ahead and we'll mark the backside before we start cleaning it up. Okay, so on the backside, it'll be opposite of the front side. The longer leg will actually go towards the driver's side. And because of the way this bracket sits, only one side of this bottom will actually go down against the frame. Put it on there, basically just even it up. We'll mark it out, and then here you can weld all around this bracket. Okay, so cleaning up the backside, as you can see, is a lot easier than cleaning up the front side. Cleaning up the front side, we're going to have to get inside this, which is really a pain. We're going to start out with a wire wheel, but chances are a lot of it we're going to end up doing just with a straight die grinder and a burr bit going in there and making sure we get all the rust off. And really, this is probably the hardest part about this whole installation is just getting all that rust off. Alright, so with this cleaned up, what we've done is we've taken both our parts and looked and saw what the back side of each part was. And we went in, we sprayed it with some weld through primer. That way the paint hopefully will survive most of the welding process. Now you want to be careful you don't get a ton on these outside edges, because if you have a ton of that primer on these outside edges, you could have a problem with getting good welds in there. Then we basically just got a magnet on a stick here, and we'll use that to help us place this in the position and hold it there while we get our tacks made. Now before we do that, before we start welding, one thing I will say is that I would recommend removing your negative ground cable from your battery. It's highly unlikely that you would cause an issue where you run a voltage spike through your computer or something like that, or some other sensor. But in general, I just do it on all vehicles. I weld on no matter what. All right, we'll get it in here. We'll tack it in place. Now, if you have already somewhat bent this, obviously you're going to have to open it up. And when you do that, chances are you're not going to fit real well. Once you get it tacked in place pretty good here, you could take and close up some of these gaps that you have here if you do have some large gaps. Unfortunately, I mean, the consistency of this bracket is a little bit difficult to hit sometimes. So then we can go ahead and weld it up. Now when you weld this, I would recommend not putting all your heat right away into this area up here. You don't want to start melting your bushing. So we're going to put a couple welds here, move down, come back, and basically alter where we're welding just to not allow the local heat to get too high and melt that bushing. Okay, so one thing to remember when you're welding this, one on this side, you're pretty close to this edge, so you may burn back that edge a little bit, and we got a little bit hot. We did that in this case, and it won't be an issue. Down here, there's a small slot at the bottom that is to allow mud and rocks and other things to make its way out of the inside of this this control arm mount, so don't weld that shut on the front side, but on the back we will go ahead and weld that shut. All right, so that does it for the welding of the reinforcement kit for your TJ or Cherokee upper control arm mount on your Dana 30. Of course, now you're going to need to let it cool, prime it, paint it, make sure it doesn't corrode. Then you can go in and reinstall your control arm, your upper control arm, and your steering stabilizer. Now, when you install that upper control arm, you may need to use a ratchet strap to pull the axle forward or back just a little bit. Make sure that bolt lines up cleanly. Then you get it all bolted back up, torqued back down, and you're ready to roll. So thanks for watching, and if you have any questions, you can get a hold of us at taboocustoms.com, or you can find us on Facebook or Instagram. Thanks.